he's going to have a good test tonight, because the talk of the National Hockey League right now is the guy at the other end, Ben Bishop. Three shutouts in a row, and I believe if he gets to 15 or 16 minutes this period, we hope that doesn't happen. The Wild can get on the board first. It'll be a franchise record for Ben Bishop.
He goes back after it. Lovejoy fights off a check, then he's blasted by Foligno.
Come on, fight him.
Foligno threw a heavy hit. Radulov pressured by Suter. Loose puck in the corner. Pollock had it for a moment, got it back to Radulov, and around behind for Haskinen. Stars efficiently out of their zone. They come back through neutral ice. Hintz takes a return pass, and Dubnyk comes out to challenge and makes the save. Centering pass knocked away by Dubnyk. Greenway hit by Lovejoy. Aberg out to the line for Hunt. Hunt shot blocked by Janmark. Hunt knocks it out of the air. Hand pass waved off as Fax is the first man to play it. Odd man rush for the Stars. And a quick shot knocked away by Dubnyk. Como digging away for the rebound, and it's picked up and cleared by Aberg. A 3-on-1 for Dallas. And they've had far too many odd man rushes here in the first period. Janmark has it along the wall. Tried to go to Fax in behind. Out to the point. Pull on. Como, they score! It was tipped by Faxa in the high slot, and Dallas, for the fourth time in four meetings, has the first goal.
Yeah, we talk about how important it was going to be to get that first goal here tonight. Obviously, the Dallas Stars get that one, but I mean, we're going to show the goal in the replay, but the turnovers that led up to this, two times in the defensive zone, you heard Bob Woods talk about it. When he talked to Kevin Gorg about managing the puck, making sure you take care of the puck, make those smart plays in the defensive zone, the Minnesota Wild with a big deflection out there in front. We talked about how important it was going to be.
Dubnyk with a sprawling save on Hintz, and then on the rebound, Dallas thinks they've scored. Dubnyk thought he had the puck under his pad, and the officials will confirm.
But from here, it did not look. Yeah, I mean, he did not point to the net like it was a goal. And he was in. I was looking at where he was. He was in outstanding position to see it.
I'm not sure why they were celebrating.
Oh,
I don't think this is a situation where the officials would have been blowing it dead. It looked like it got through the pads of Dubnyk.
Determine that the puck don't cross the goal line, we have a good goal.
So the goal stands. You may have seen Boudreau there on a shot of the Minnesota bench, really laying into his team. This has not been a gripping performance by the Wild thus far.
No, it hasn't been, but here's the view that everybody needs to see right there.
Even more disciplined defensively with a two-goal lead.
Yeah, and that's the thing with the Dallas Stars. The way they're playing defensively, they just have so much confidence right now. They're going into games feeling like if they score two or three goals.
Well, here's three. L'Espérance with his first in the NHL on the deflection of the Jamie Benn pass. And the Stars have scored three times in a span of 2 minutes and 22 seconds. And it's 3-0 for the visitors.
Yeah, this is a difficult start here for the Minnesota Wild. Jamie Benn, the heart and soul of their club, getting outnumbered in front of the net, 3-2, and that's the first point and first goal of this kid's career. 29 goal in 50 games in the AHL. This guy knows how to put the puck in the net, and he buried it. They're up 3-0. If you got a chance to get the puck to the net, you don't have to worry about the next play, because the next play is the puck is going to the goalie.
See those numbers on the Wild power play.
Just like
that. And they score! Zucker on the rebound!
How nice is this to see? This rink is hopping here right now. Everybody's out of their seat. Let's see if this is something that can ignite the Minnesota Wild. Again, this is exactly what they worked on. Jason Zucker right in front of the goalie, and everybody crashing the net. You could see Luke Cunnan. You could see Luke Cunnan here going to the net as quick as he could, even right behind Jason Zucker. So everybody knew that if the puck was going to the net, and they were going to crash it as quick as they could. So getting an opportunity in practice, Anthony, and working on some entries out of the zone and working on some plays around the front of the net. Sometimes after Christmas, you don't have that luxury to practice as much as you possibly like.
Rebound held by Parisi. A lot of shot attempts coming from wide for Minnesota throughout the night here tonight.
Look where Ryan Suter is keeping that puck alive. Even when Cunning shot that puck, guess who was right behind him? That guy right there.
Spurgeon with a quick shot and a pad save by Hudobin. Spurgeon holds. Suter in the corner. Centers! Loose puck and it's kicked just wide. Fiala works past Pollock. Gives to Parisi. Parisi off the pad of Hudobin with Cunning right there. And finally, Hudobin able to cover Minnesota's best 3 minutes of the night. Sagan pressured by Rask. Puck goes back in behind the Minnesota goal. Hintz is there out to the line. Haskinen a shot. Save Dubnyk. A wraparound try by Sagan. And Dubnyk sprawls across to make the save. Stahl tried the center. Hit the back of the net. Ben controls. Suter cannot hold and finds Sagan moving in with the empty net. And he sends it over the top of the goal. And boy, oh boy, Sagan and Radulov lost the one sure goal on an offside call. And now Sagan here couldn't get rid of this one before Spurgeon got back. I'm not sure how he missed this one over the top like this.
Looked like that was a sandwich. He needed his four iron. He had his sandwich there. When you've got a two-goal lead like they do right now, the Dallas Stars, sometimes if you're a star player, guys like Sagan, Radulov.
Donato lost the puck along the boards. Fiala tries to hold. Sagan out to Radulov. Sidesteps Fiala. And this time he makes no mistake and scores. And the Stars ice it. It's 4-1 Dallas. And Minnesota's struggles on home ice continue. The Wild have now lost 17 of their last 23 in this building.
Any chance to just even give ourselves a chance to get there? This was a very, very important win for the Dallas Stars. Puts them 5 points up of the Minnesota Wild. And in all honesty, Anthony, I say this a million times before, 95% of the time you get what you deserve. The Minnesota Wild were not ready to play in this game. The first half of the game found themselves down 3-0. And that was all she wrote.